Mandeep, what is a beat for Nvidia today? Because a beat for Nvidia is very different to a beat for everybody else.
Yeah, look, I think we've gone from skepticism around what's the kind of the revenue run rate and margins, how long can they hold that, to really nothing could go wrong for Nvidia, even though there are a lot of issues, you know, when it comes to the China exposure and hyperscalers developing their own chips. And anytime you see headlines like Nvidia surpassing Alphabet or Amazon in market cap, you have to ask yourself, you know, what is the fundamental business that Nvidia is in versus all these other giants, which have, if you look at the sum of the parts valuation, they've got multiple businesses. So really, expectations are getting ahead of themselves, and there will be a point where, you know, it will be hard to just manage expectations. And I think Nvidia probably is at that point. But look, they could come out and beat by double digits again, because we know every incremental CapEx dollar right now is going towards buying the chips, because there is literally a shortage of what they're making.
We'll get to China in 1 second, but Mandeep, do we have a sense of what the saturation point is for demand for all of these chips at this point, at the development that they're at?
I mean, you go back in time, you know, with chips, typically there is a digestion phase. And right now, the customer base is incredibly concentrated for these chips. It's your hyperscalers, your Microsoft, Google, Amazon. These are the biggest customers of Nvidia's chips. And they're buying because of their cloud business. But at some point, it has to translate into revenue numbers for these companies. And right now, we know Microsoft is the only one that has quantified the revenue impact. The others are still developing that capacity because they can afford to keep buying it. But that I think the margin impact is crucial, because if Nvidia's margins have grown 10%, it's coming at the expense of some other player. It's either the software players or like further application layer. And that is where you have to ask yourself, how long can they sustain that margins, and at whose expense it's coming?